This is the moment it all changed. I mean, the moment that it started to get really, really good. You're probably wondering what I'm talking about. When I decided that I wanted to be super specific about who I served and who I work with, things started to just flow and happen so naturally. It was incredible. When I went to this previous year, a Tony Robbins event, he said something that totally clicked in my head. He was talking about the mistake that so many entrepreneurs make. So many of us fall in love with our product or our service, when in reality, we should fall in love with the type of person that we serve. So when I got super, super intentional about who I serve, which for me is purpose-driven female entrepreneurs, everything started to change and worked so well. So I decided that I wanted to work with these women because they're driven to make an impact in the world, to make the world a better place, as am I. And not only that, I not only thought of this individual as a client, but a friend. And that made me want to add so much more value and go the extra mile and above and beyond so much more. Don't get me wrong, I'm always trying to over deliver, but when I wasn't super intentional about the type of clients that I was working with, I would basically take on any client that liked my portfolio and liked the results that I'd been able to create and had enough funds to pay me. Now, I definitely wanted to be serving them and valuable to them and do what I said I would do, but going the extra mile when you genuinely love the person that you're working for comes as second nature. It's just something that you do naturally, and it made things flow so easily. Additionally, business development and sales just started to click like this because I was talking their language. I was already that individual. So talking to someone who was similar to me, it was really easy. And I got super clear on my marketing and my messaging. And they saw that and felt my authenticity and my realness and my purpose and my desire to serve. And it created this relatability and this likability, and the sales just started to really flow super easily. So in today's video, I want to show you how to get super intentional and how to choose a customer that you can fall in love with as well. So things start flowing for you and you start reaping the benefits of this dream client. Before we get started, it would mean the world to me if you would subscribe to my channel. It's that red button right below. I drop new videos every Tuesday about entrepreneurship, mindset, and marketing. I am always looking for ways to add more value to entrepreneurs who are like me and who I was once like. I always am looking to add value and to help improve the lives of others. So if that's something that you're interested in, if you're new to this entrepreneurship journey, or if you're just getting started, or if you've been at it for a while, but you're looking for tips on marketing, strategies for entrepreneurship, or just mindset shifts that I've made that have totally catapulted my life and my business and my happiness, definitely subscribe. Step number one to choosing your dream client. You have to think about the skills that you have, whether it's a product or a service, or you're not sure exactly what you're even going to offer. You have a plethora of skills. What you need to think about is who those skills really serve. Who can you create transformations for? Whose lives can you positively impact? For me, creating 6 months of marketing content for purpose-driven female entrepreneurs in just 3 days is so valuable to these women because then they have the opportunity to spend time spreading their message, enjoying their family, taking care of themselves, and their marketing runs on autopilot. So for them, that is a major transformation, especially since many of these women are so used to doing everything themselves and being, you know, in control of everything and having to worry about everything. When they work with us, they get to reap so many more benefits because they don't have to worry about their marketing day in and day out. So I knew that I could create a huge transformation in the lives of purpose-driven female entrepreneurs. Whose lives can you create a major transformation for? That is step number one. Step number two is figuring out what your ideal clientele's needs are. What do they want? What do they desire? What do they want more of? And do your product and services really fit in there? Can you really help them to the best of your ability? Can you serve them? Does your service or product meet their requirements? Because we are not in the game of selling to everybody. We want to serve people and actually fix problems that people have. That's why we're in business. So making sure that your product or service really lines up with their needs and their desires is so important. Number three, which might be the most important step. I'm not sure, they're all pretty important, but this one's really good. Write down a list of who your ideal client is not. Who you would absolutely not like to work with. What attributes do they have? Are they lazy? Do they complain a lot? Do they not take a lot of action? How much income do they make? Like, are they, maybe if you have a $10,000 product, you're gonna say, my ideal clientele is not making less than $100,000 a year. Make sure that you're super clear about who is not your ideal clientele. The more specific you can get in this process, the better. It's going to make your marketing so much easier because when you're creating new content, you're gonna know exactly who you're speaking to and who you're not speaking to. It allows you to improve your messaging and it makes it so much simpler. Step four is to think of some stories that you can tell your ideal client. Start writing down transformations that you've had that makes you valuable to them, stories about how your services or products can help lives of people similar to them. Start thinking, brainstorming, do a brain dump of all the stories that you can tell that lead back to why, you know, value, adding value to their lives and why you would be a good fit to work with for them. Get super specific. If you really were thorough in the last three steps, this last step should be super simple for you, and I know you are going to be so successful. You see, when you take the time to do this, you are allowing yourself to fall in love again with that customer and really make adding value a no-brainer. You know, I just landed somebody that I've had on my vision board for 2 years as a client, and working with her, I'm like, this doesn't feel like work. This is amazing. I don't care how much time it takes. Everything I'm doing, how can I over deliver for this client? How can I make sure that I'm being as valuable as possible to this individual? And once you do that, like once I have over delivered for this individual client, she's going to be talking about my service to other people that are like-minded to her because that's her social circle. And then I will be getting referrals from them. So just start with, you know, focusing on one person that you can really serve and over delivering for them, somebody that you could fall in love with, that you would want to spend time with, whether you are working together or not, and somebody that can afford your services. And your life and business is going to get so good. I am so excited for you. If you guys want more help on creating your customer avatar, I am providing a free download in the description below. So make sure to download that and I will help you go through all these steps and give you the layout for it, as well as coming up with your messaging and your stories that you're gonna tell in your marketing campaigns. I am so excited for you. This is going to be such a game changer, and I can't wait to hear your results. Tell me who your ideal customer is below in the comments, and I can't wait to talk with you guys soon. One last thing, if you enjoyed this video, please give me a thumbs up, like it, and subscribe to my channel, and I will talk to you soon. Peace out, boo.